Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Learning Electronics. In this video we are going to learn about base spreading resistance of transistor. So before that, please subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon so that you can get more updated videos from here. So let us start the topic, base spreading resistance, RBB dash. We have taken one NPN transistor with its three terminals, emitter, base and collector. The base spreading resistance is studied when the transistor is operating in active mode. So in active mode of operation, emitter base junction of the transistor is forward biased, collector base junction of the transistor is reverse biased. Collector base junction of the transistor is reverse biased means at collector base junction, N side of the transistor is connected with positive terminal of the battery and P side of the transistor is connected with negative terminal of the battery. Similarly, emitter base junction is forward biased means at emitter base junction, N side of the transistor is connected with negative terminal of the battery and P side of the transistor is connected with positive terminal of the battery. And as we can see in this diagram, due to diffusion process, already depletion, two depletion layers are formed at emitter base junction and collector base junction. Now we know that the width of the base region is very thin as compared to collector and emitter as shown in the figure. Therefore, the current which enters the base region across the emitter base junction has a narrow path to reach the base terminal. And the resistance offered by this narrow path region is called as base spreading resistance and it is designated by RBB dash. So, on increasing the value of reverse bias VCB, that is collector to base voltage, the width of the collector base region depletion layer increases. Means on increasing the value of the reverse bias voltage, the depletion layer width increases. Since the base region is lightly doped, the depletion layer penetrates deep into the base region than that of the collector at the collector base junction. Thus, the value of this base spreading resistance increases by increasing the reverse bias voltage across the collector base junction with the increase of the depletion layer. Since the depletion layer penetrates deep into the base region than that of the collector, the cross section area of the base region is reduced. Smaller the cross section area means larger the base spreading resistance. The resistance of emitter and collector region is very small as these regions are much larger in size as compared to the base. And they are heavily doped as compared to base. Usually, the value of base spreading resistance is between 50 to 150 ohms. When the recombination current IB passes through this resistance, it produces some voltage drop across it. Its effect is considered at high frequencies, but at low frequencies, the effect of base spreading resistance is ignored. Now we will see with the increase of this collector to base voltage, that is reverse bias voltage, how this depletion layer is increasing and how the resistance of this base region is increasing with the increase of this depletion layer width with the animation. So when we increase the value of collector to base voltage, the depletion layer width will increase like this, and this region's resistance, means the resistance of the base region due to the increase of the depletion layer is called as base spreading resistance, RBB dash. So that's all for now. Thank you very much for watching and please do subscribe my channel.